I'm Rick Everson, and welcome back to Outlook Portland on Northwest 32 TV. By the way, during this final segment, whatever you do, don't be at all distracted by any of the photos back here in the frames, especially not the Portland signed or the fact that the flag on the bridge over here is at half mast.
Flaccid, I think.
Don't see, and what I was referring to with some vagueness, you have to bring a sort of tawdry specificity to.
Thank you.
Let's talk a little bit about the writing process. I've tried my hand at some writing some stage plays and writing some other sorts of things, and it's usually a little bit of a solitary process, at least in the beginning. But when you're writing a musical, I mean, it's like 100 different things that all have to come together at once. How does that writing process even begin?
That's a wonderful question. It's collaborative, first of all. It's not solitary. The only time you go off by yourself is after you meet with your partners and you discuss areas that you wish to discover or to explore, and then you go off on yourself and you come up with ideas, and then you present them to the partners, and the partners discuss them and kind of decide which way to go.
Sure. We may be a little bit unique, though, too, and the way that Brad and I, the lyricist and I, have always worked comes out of the Lehman Engel Musical Theater Workshop from Lehman Engel, who taught us. We were both involved in the LA workshop at the time. But essentially, we've refined it down to working an outline, building the outline collaboratively with all three partners involved, getting it as solid as we think it can in terms of telling the story arcs, the subplots, making sure that they follow through, trying to get some peer review, get their feedback, make appropriate changes, and then getting together, in this case, since it's a musical, and using a term from film, spotting the piece, so we're spotting where the songs go, how the songs push the story forward, where the scenes are built, emotional high points, things like that. And then once the songs are spotted, and we've talked about every element from the subject matter to their intention, what the intention of the song is, to the style of music, to how long it might be, those sort of things, and who's singing it, and how many choruses, how many bridges, how many verses. Then we separate, and we go our separate way, and there's a lot of email and telephone calls.
Break it out into sections.
Right, and J.P. was writing the script, the dialogue, usually a couple scenes ahead of Brad and I. And Brad and I, either Brad would write lyric first, or I write my music first. It just depends, and pass them back and forth.
You mentioned Los Angeles, and I know that a lot of the people involved in this have worked in other cities, Los Angeles and in the Hollywood area, and you guys have got a lot of experience in places that are not Portland, but many... Portland does seem to be a little bit of a magnet for creative people of a certain bent. What is the appeal there, if you can quantify it in some way? Why does Portland seem to attract a certain breed of artist? What is it about the city?
I think because of the freedom, really. I think Portland is, we were discussing this in the car, I think Portland is what San Francisco always wanted to be. I think people come to Portland to really be weird or to really explore their creative side. And that's why all these artists are coming from. Our videographer, Brett Vail's from L.A. Both Kurt and I have lived in L.A. and worked in L.A.
And Brad is there
and
now.
But Portland, you have a chance of getting it up and produced, a better chance here than you would maybe in L.A. or San Francisco. And there's a community here of wonderful artists that I think are very supportive and that have a high percentage of actually getting their stuff done. That's why I think people come here.
And now, with an Outlook Portland editorial reply, Things from Another World presents Godzilla, King of the Monsters.
Hello. I come to you today not as a fire-breathing beast of ultimate fury and destruction, but as an advocate for local theater. In an age when we as Americans seem to find more and more to dislike about one another, in a time when it's easier to disparage than praise, I stand here with a simple reminder that you speak loudest with your actions. When confronted with a choice between the ordinary and the adventurous, when facing a decision about your entertainment or cultural pursuits, keep in mind always, people of Portland, that the most direct way to support the art you love is to support the art you love. Buy a ticket, see a show, tell a friend, and if you can, lend a hand in some particular way. For as I, Godzilla, King of the Monsters, want you to remember, creativity is a flower best nourished with the water of community. Portland has much to be proud of. An empathetic and responsive system of social agencies, a true commitment to preserving the beauty of nature, and a stunning array of choices for patrons of the stage. Help preserve that variety with your dollars and your devotion, and the result will come back to all of us tenfold. Thank you.
J.P. Lindy and Kurt Misor. The play is Wild Space, a Go-Go, and it is at the Embers Avenue through May 30th. You can find out more about it at
WildSpaceAGoGo.com.
Good, yeah.
I'm glad you covered for me there because I completely forgot. My name is Rick Emerson. If you find me even moderately amusing, you can find out more about this program at OutlookPortland.com, or you can email us a show topic or guest suggestion. It's Rick at OutlookPortland.com. Until next time, thank you for watching. Insert trademark catchphrase here. We will see you next Sunday right here on Outlook Portland on Northwest 32 TV. Where we talk for the year.
Okay. I was going to say that's one long
catchphrase. Wow. What a great interview.
That was really good.